Dear students, welcome back to the second semester BSc Physics class. In this session, we shall discuss about Laplace's correction to the Newton's formula. In the previous session, we have discussed and deduced an expression for the velocity of sound in a medium, which is the velocity of a longitudinal wave in a medium. The medium may be air. This was also called as the Newton's formula for the sound propagating in a medium. This was given by V is equal to square root of E by rho, where E is the volume elasticity of the medium and rho is the density of the medium. The equation 1 here is known as Newton's formula for the velocity of a plane longitudinal wave in an elastic medium of volume elasticity. While deducing this equation, Newton assumed that the phenomenon of propagation of sound wave in air is an isothermal process. Isothermal process is that process in which the temperature remains constant in the medium. For this assumption, Newton gave the reason that during the propagation of sound wave, the amount of heat generated in the region of compression is dissipated to the region of rarefaction and the temperature of the medium remains constant. While the propagation of the sound wave, there will be compressions and rarefactions in the medium. These compressions will make the medium to gain heat, and during the rarefaction the heat will be dissipated and the temperature will remain constant. So this was the assumption of Newton while deducing the equation for the velocity of sound in the air medium. Hence, Newton applied Boyle's law. Boyle's law says that the pressure of the medium is inversely proportional to velocity, or we can give the equation as PV is equal to constant. He applied this equation and deduced the expression and calculated the velocity of sound in air. According to Newton, if the pressure in the medium is increased from P to P plus dP, it results in a decrease of volume from V to V minus dV. As the pressure increases, the volume of the medium obviously decreases. So this small change in the pressure dP will exert on the medium and the volume will be reduced. The small volume reduced is dV. According to Boyle's law, we can write PV is equal to, substituting for P and V, we can write PV is equal to P plus dP into V minus dV. This becomes multiplying PV is equal to PV minus P into dV plus D into PV minus dP into dV. By rearranging this one, we get PV minus PV is equal to minus PdV plus dPV minus dP dV. Here, the term dP DV can be neglected, since if there is increase in pressure DP is very small, then the decrease in the volume DV will also be very small. Hence this term DP into DV in the equation can be neglected, and the equation becomes 0 is equal to minus PdV plus DPV, or this can be written as PdV is equal to DPV. This again can be written as, in terms of the pressure, we can write the equation as P is equal to DP into V by DV, that is equal to DP divided by DV by V. So here DP is the change in pressure, which will be a stress in the medium, and the change in volume to the original volume, that is the term DV by V, represents the strain produced in the medium. This ratio of stress by strain gives a constant which is known as the elasticity of the medium, E, which is also known as the isothermal elasticity of the medium. Therefore, substituting for E in the equation 1 above, we get V is equal to square root of E by rho, that is equal to square root of P by rho. This equation is known as the Newton's calculation for the velocity of sound in air. After verification of this equation by substituting the values for P and rho at normal temperature and pressure, that is the value for P is equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 Newton per meter square, and the density of the air rho is equal to 1.293 kg per meter cube, we get the value for the velocity of sound in air as V is equal to 280 meter per second. This value is very much lower when compared with the experimentally observed value of the velocity of sound. The experimentally observed value was found to be 332 meter per second. The value 280 meter per second is very much lower when compared to the value 332 meter per second. This is a discrepancy in the theoretical value and the experimental value. And there was an error found to be nearly 16% error was found. That implies there must be some correction done to the Newton's equation. Since Newton could not explain the discrepancy correctly, the correct explanation was given by Laplace. Now let us look into the Laplace's correction to the Newton's formula. Newton's formula for the velocity of a plane longitudinal wave, that is sound wave, in an elastic medium of volume elasticity E and density rho is V is equal to square root of E by rho, or it is square root of P by rho. Since there was a discrepancy in the values of theoretical and experimental values, the discrepancy calculated and the values of velocity of sound was explained by Laplace in the year 1816. According to Laplace, the propagation of sound wave in the air medium is not an isothermal process as assumed by Newton. But according to Laplace, The propagation of sound wave in the air medium is an adiabatic process. Laplace gave the reason for his assumption as the propagation of sound wave in the air medium is adiabatic. He gives two reasons to explain. So one is, air is an insulator, it will not conduct heat. And the second reason was, compression and rarefaction travel so fast that the rise of the temperature at compression and fall of the temperature at rarefaction do not get sufficient time to exchange heat energy to attain a constant temperature. Hence, the process was adiabatic process. So now, the velocity equation for the sound wave is equal to v is equal to square root of e by rho. The relation between p and v for the adiabatic process given by according to the Laplace, the equation was modified, that is pv nu is equal to constant, where nu is a term introduced which is known as the specific heat ratio for gas or air. It is the ratio of specific heat at constant pressure to the specific heat of the gas at constant volume. Now consider a gas having a pressure P and volume V. If its pressure is increased by a small amount dP, thereby a volume is decreased by a small amount dV, then the above equation 6 can be written as PV nu is equal to P plus dP into V minus dV to the power nu. That becomes PV nu is equal to P plus dP into V nu into 1 minus dV by V to the power nu. Multiplying on both sides by V on right hand side of the second term, we get the equation as P is equal to P plus dP into 1 minus nu into dV by V. So here binomial theorem is applied and higher order terms are neglected and the equation will be in the form this. Or this equation can be written as P is equal to P minus nu P into dV by V plus dP minus nu dP into dV by V. Rearranging the equation, we get the equation 0 is equal to minus nu P into dV by V plus dP minus nu dP into dV by V. Since the term dV is very very small than V, the term nu dP into dV by V in the above step of the equation is very small and can be neglected, and the equation can be rewritten as 0 is equal to minus nu P into dV by V plus dP. Or this can be written as nu P into dV by V, that is equal to dP, or nu P is equal to dP into V by dV. We can rearrange this as dP divided by dV by V. So where dP is the pressure exerted in the medium is called as the stress, and the term dV by V is the ratio of change in volume to the original volume, which gives the strain of the medium. In turn, this ratio stress by strain is equal to E, which is the elasticity of the medium. By considering E is equal to nu p according to Laplace and putting this value in equation 1, we get Laplace's correction to the Newton's formula for the speed of sound in air as V is equal to square root of nu p by rho. So this was the new equation given by Laplace, which is known as the Laplace's correction to the Newton's formula for the speed of sound in air. So introduced a term called nu, which is the ratio of specific heats of the gas. By applying for this equation, substituting the values of nu, p and rho, we get the calculated value of sound in air according to Laplace's equation. We get V is equal to 332.5 meter per second. So this was in well agreement with the experimental value. Hence, this is very much near to the experimental value, and the theoretical value according to this Laplace's equation is equivalent to the experimental value. Hence, this equation can be taken as a new equation for the velocity of sound in air.